Hi guys, so today we are going to do the question, build an array with stack operations. Given an array target and an integer n, in each iteration you read a number from list 1 to n. So write the target array using the following operations: push, read a new element from the beginning list, so the list is this, and push it into this array. Pop operation, delete the last element of the array. If the target array is already built, stop reading more inputs. You're guaranteed that the target array is strictly increasing and also only contains elements between 1 to n inclusive. Return the operations to build the target array. You are guaranteed that the answer is unique. So basically what we have to do is that we have to build the target array from a list that is from 1 to n. The n input is given to us, like for this example we have n equal to 3. So the list we can imagine it to be for this instance we can imagine the list to have values 1, 2 and 3. So basically we have to read the elements from the start of the list and we have to check whether this element exists in the target array or not. If yes, then we just do a push operation. Then we increment the pointer we are looking at. So now we are looking at value 2. So value 2 is being looked here, but we see that the target array has only elements 1 and 3. So in this case 2 does not have to be present in the target array. So what we do is we first push the element 2 into the target array, but then we perform a pop operation. Using the pop operation, we are just removing the element. So we first do a push. Then we again do a push operation, but then 2 is not required, so we do a pop operation. So now after this step, what is the how is the target present, what is the value of the target array? It is this, because we added 1, then we added 2, but we then popped it off, so only 1 is present right now. Then we continue to iterate. We encounter the element 3. We check if it is present in the target array or not. Yes, it is present, so that we simply push the element and we do not pop it. Now since we have reached the end of the target array, so we end our operations and we simply return the vector of string that we have already built. So this was simple. So we'll look to the other example as well so that you understand it better. Quite simple algorithm to solve this question. For this sample input we have 1, 2, 3 and n is 3. So we first we are given this target array, like we can see that we are given this array. So we read the first element. We'll take a counter which would be reading from 1 to n. Fine. So if the counter value is equal to the value at the ith index of the target, then we simply do a push operation. That means we are inserting that element into the final vector of string. Fine. Then we encounter 2 and also we increment the value of count. So 2 is equal to target of position. Position is a variable that we are using to denote the ith index of the target array. Fine, so since 2 is also present, 2 is equal to 2, so we just simply push the element. And again we increment both position and the counter variable. So again 3 is equal to 3, so we simply push it. So we are pushing it. So that is how the final answer is made, and we simply return it. So it is a quite simple logic. I'll code that for you. So vector of string is what needs to be returned. So I'm making one here. Then what I do is I'll take a variable named counter, which will start from 1 and it will go up to n. Fine. Then I'll take a variable I, which will start from the 0th index of the target vector. I iterate through the target array. Now while I is less than target dot size, or okay, so basically we are iterating till the end of the target array, and then the counter variable is equal to target of I. So basically what we are doing is taken I is equal to 0 and the counter equal to 1. So basically we are at the 0th position. We check if 1 equal to 1. So in this case we just do a push operation. Then we'll increment the counter variable. So counter plus equal to 1 we'll do here. So counter will become 2 here. Then we'll also increment the I. So what will the target of I point to now? 3. But 2 is not equal to 3. That means the element 2 is not present in the array. Fine. So what we do is we do a push, then we do a pop. So let me do this. So if it is equal, then what I do is I'll add a push operation, and also I will increment the I counter. Else what I will do is I will push as well as pop. Fine. So these are the two operations in case the counter is not equal to target of I, and if it is, so we increment the I position as well. Here we are not incrementing it, and then for each time we are incrementing the pointer, the counter value, and we simply return the answer from the code. We should be running it now. So okay, so I haven't written capital A's here. This has given me a correct answer. We'll try some more examples. We'll try the fourth example, that is 2, 3, 4, and we'll give an input n as 4. This is giving a correct answer, let's submit it. And we've got a very fast and efficient solution. So we are doing it in order of n time and order of one space. The extra vector that we have made is for the output, but we haven't used any additional data structure while solving the question. So this is basically the return type, hence this will not be counted as extra space. So I hope it is very clear to you. Thank you for watching. Bye-bye.